Carmen Eat, Shan Shan Audio Web Novel Chapter 17 Big Boss, actually lied to her. Ha 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 ha, it is not her, it is not her. Shan Shan almost cries in relief, happiness, justice still exists in this world. Shan Shan suddenly looks at the world full of confidence, applauding loudly along with everyone else. Amidst the applause, Zhou Xiaowei stands still flushing red, looking shyly towards Fang Teng. Fang Teng is expressionless. Shan Shan thinks Big Boss has lost on his investment, so he must be feeling unhappy. He can direct his anger towards his partner, which is her. As she looks to escape, Fang Teng scowls at her. Wait for me here, don't go anywhere. Greater than underscore less than directing his anger towards her now. He will go dance with a beauty but commands her to stand here looking silly. The music of a waltz begins. Fang Teng walks towards Zhou Xiaowei, politely invites her to dance. Zhou Xiaowei shyly puts her hand into his extended hand. They glide onto the dance floor. Zhou Xiaowei is exceptionally beautiful tonight. She must have spent a lot of effort dressing up. She wears a white chiffon dress leaving her shoulders bare. In front of her chest is a transparent layer of white lace that appears pure but seductive at the same time. A small diamond tiara is slightly tilted in her softly curled hair, glittering brightly, making her ethereal and fragile. She looks up at the tall man dancing with her, her gaze bashful and innocent. Shan Shan stands on the outside watching them dance, her eyes gradually shifting lower to Zhou Xiaowei's waist, where Big Boss is resting his paw. How lecherous. How very lecherous. Wonder which pervert thought of the waltz. It is just an excuse for men and women to touch each other. Shan Shan silently curses. Initially, her mood is very joyful and high but somewhat inexplicably falling. On the dance floor, Fang Teng and Zhou Xiaowei turn in circles several times. They do not look dizzy, but Shan Shan feels dizzy the more she watches them. Probably too much alcohol, probably needs to sit down a bit. Shan Shan walks to a buffet table to get some cold food then sits down to eat to replenish her energy. That is the most important thing. She was a dummy to obey Big Boss's command to stand there and wait for him. While eating, another voice calls out, Miss Zhu. This person causes her to choke again. Shan Shan looks up and smiles, greeting him, Mr. Yan. Yan King asks courteously, I wonder if I may have the pleasure to invite Miss Zhu to a dance. Shan Shan is embarrassed, that, I don't know how to dance. Yan King smiles thoughtfully, sitting here to talk is good too. After saying this, he sits down across from Shan Shan. Shan Shan asks worriedly, Miss Fang is feeling better. Yan King hears mention of Fang Yu, his face is filled with gratitude. Thanks for your help, she is no longer in danger, she is slowly being nursed back to health, these things can't be rushed. Oh no, listening to him makes Shan Shan feel guilty, but Big Boss does not allow her to say the truth. Shan Shan quickly searches for a new topic. I heard Miss Fang was in Europe, when did she get back? Europe? Yan King asks in surprise, we traveled there for our honeymoon. But we haven't returned in 2 years, do you plan to go for a vacation? Fang Yu wants to go back, we can go together when she feels better. Shan Shan is shocked into silence. The first dance is ending. Ahmei and Linda are not dancing but sitting on the outside to gossip. Ahmei is envious of the prize money, her voice tinged with a bit of dissatisfaction. Linda laughs and says teasingly, you shouldn't be jealous, the investment she spent is 10 times what you spent. Ahmei is surprised, Linda, everything I'm wearing isn't cheap. Linda laughs out loud and looks towards the dance floor, slowly listing the luxurious brands on Zhou Xiaowei, then challenges Ahmei again, see, ready to admit defeat. Ahmei's reluctance fades away, sighing, she is just a small staff but willing to spend so much money. Linda quips, a wine lover's heart is not in the cup, having an ulterior motive, if you don't fork out, you won't reap big profit. Ahmei laughs knowingly, but I bet, even if she spends 10 times more, the president will invite Shan Shan for the next dance. On the dance floor, the first dance ends, Fang Teng drops his hands, nods politely to say goodbye and is about to walk away. Zhou Xiaowei calls out urgently, President. Fang Teng pauses to look at her. The music for the second dance begins. Ahmei is startled to see the president is not dancing with Shan Shan like she had thought. The second dance he is still with Zhou Xiaowei. Everyone else is also shocked, thinking, has Zhou Xiaowei's beauty tonight melted the heart of the president? Everyone unintentionally shifts sympathetic eyes towards Shan Shan, who is considered the official girlfriend, but left standing by alone. They see her looking blankly, distracted, as if she has taken a blow. The truth is that Shan is not paying attention to the unusual atmosphere in the ballroom. Unaware of everyone focusing on her, she is not even aware that the second dance has started. After Yan King has left to answer a phone call, she is immobilized in this position, completely shocked. Big Boss actually lied to her. Miss Fang did not go to Europe. So who sent the lunchboxes? Could it be Big Boss? But why? To exploit her, to enslave her. Or? Shan feels uneasy, her heart thumps heavily, as if something is about to burst free out of its cocoon. Ah ha ha, impossible, impossible, Shan quickly pushes it back. She must have drunk too much to think so strangely. Wine is really bad, giving her strange thoughts, she could not help but look to the dance floor. Fang Teng and Zhou Xiaowei are still dancing. At that moment Fang Teng turns his back to her, Zhou Xiaowei sees her and smiles gently. Shan does not notice her. She looks at Fang Teng's sturdy back, her head becoming heavier and heavier. Shan wants to go outside to sober up, staying inside any longer and she feels she is slowly being taken over by a demon. As a result, those who are paying close attention to what is happening will testify. Zhu Shan stares at the president and Zhou Xiaowei on the dance floor in jealousy, then stands up in anger and walking outside looking troubled.